All right, y'all, Rick and Smile, the morning show. On the phone, we got Hall of Famer, the one and only Deion Primetime Sanders. Woo! Hey, what up, dog?
What's going on, my brother?
Man, that commercial with you flying around, dog, love it.
And the check cleared.
I know. Hey, must be the money.
Hey.
What up, dog? How everything going, man?
And everything is so blessed. I can't complain, man. We're getting ready to open up our charter school in 2012, the fall, in Fort Worth as well as in Dallas. We got town hall meetings. And guess what, man? Not only that, we coming to Atlanta, man. We're coming to Atlanta. Yeah. Truth is coming to Atlanta.
That is. Yeah, come on, y'all. One time for this. So what's the charter school all about? What inspired it?
Well, it started with just education. I still believe that our kids should have the best education as possible. We're hiring 100 teachers from all around the country, teachers, administrators, et cetera. They could go to primeprepacademy.org for more information on that. We create jobs, man. We're just trying to bless people and just give these kids the best opportunities. Every kid in the school will receive a free laptop. All their work and assignments and the curriculum will be on a laptop computer. 21st century technology that we're implementing. It's going to be off the hook, Gary.
So would you say that, you know, each student will have more of a personal relationship with their teacher versus someone going to a public school?
Yeah, well, the thing about there are some great public schools. I'm not going to knock that. But there's some great private schools as well. Just to blend the two and just let people understand that this is really the future. This is really the next technology. But to really have the relationship, you got to involve the parents, man. The parents got to play a major role in just getting there to make sure their kids are doing their work.
All right, so Deion, you know you like family to us.
Yeah, thank you.
And tell us what's going on with everything in the news. Just
you got to be more specific.
The divorce.
Well, let me just tell you.
You know what we're talking about. We fan. Come on.
Dog, we love y'all, dog. We are crushed, dog.
It's a hot mess. You haven't seen a quote from me. I don't have TMZ on speed dial or anything like that. I don't call them. That's not me. When we contact them, we're defending ourselves, and it's very unfortunate. Next thing you know, I'm gonna be running around with Juicy. Me and Gary gonna be taking it. You know.
What's wrong with that?
Yeah. Being Juicy kicking the Knicks.
Hey, Prime, you know Juicy got that fire. They say it's sweet when it's low to the ground.
Super duper.
So, Deion, how's the children doing out of all this? Because I'm sure they're reading and their classmates probably telling them about what's going on with your parents and stuff. So how's that happening?
My older kids are darn near grown. You know, Deion just 21, and you know she ain't having it. And Bucky's junior, he's 18. So, and they understand he's much more mature than any of them. But then my boys are 12 and 10 years old. They know exactly what's going on, and they can read as well as my daughter. So when you see stuff starting to disappear in the house and things like that, you know, those questions have to be answered. And unfortunately, this is the situation. I wish to God that their ignorant attorney and their adolescent and incompetent attorney would keep this stuff out of the media, but that's what he wants to do. That's the game he wants to play, which is ignorant to us. It really is. You think we want to defend ourselves every week with another foolish accusation?
Right. That's got to be challenging. Yeah.
Now, Deion, how do you police everything? Like, with social media being so popular, I know you probably heard a few weeks ago, like, your daughter went on this Twitter rant, going at your ex. Like, I mean, how do you control all that?
You can't. You can just try to be the father that God has called you to be and tell your baby girl, look, baby girl, you hold on, player. Hold on. Now, just let it be. I know you got daddy back, but thank you. Let us handle this. And she's been pretty good, but when she's constantly being attacked as well, it's hard for a 21-year-old daughter who loves their father to just sit back on the sideline and not say nothing. And when they know what's going on the inside. But it's really hard on the kids, not only that, my whole youth organization, because they know me. They see me every day, and they see me going through this stuff. But the key word is going through it, because the enemy has attacked me, man. I'm opening 2 schools, K-12. Do you hear me? K-12.
Amen.
100,000 kids every day in the summer months. I'm hiring 50 to 100 kids from the age of 17 to 22. Now I'm bringing the truth to Atlanta on March the 7th at Centennial at the Holiday Inn downtown to have a collective meeting. Then I'm doing trials here in Atlanta on May the 19th and 20th for Truth North and South. So we're doing some huge things in the community. Then ultimately I'm going to open up a school here. So the enemy is just trying
That's
to
awesome.
Stop me before I get started.
We're talking to Deion Sanders, and the other day, earlier this week, there was something that I don't want to say if it was leaked or a phone call made or a recording where I believe it was your aunt and Pilar actually had altercation. Who taped that?
She did. She has been secretly, privately recording me for the last 3.5 months. Thank God that I'm the same person I am in the dark that I am in the light, that it was no ignorant, nothing on there, because if so, you guys would have heard it. And that thing fell out of her pocket during the skirmish that they had, and my aunt picked it up.
So you and her are staying in the house together, right? Y'all are still both living in the same...
You stand in the same house, but I'm abusive, I'm this, I'm that. The kids ain't eating. all that ignorant stuff. It just makes you sick to your stomach.
Well, yep. Deion, are you paying for sex? Because she said that you wanted, the only way you would give her money, she had to have sex with you?
Yeah, if I was doing that, that would have been on the tape that was being privately recorded over the last 3 months that I had no knowledge about. That's called tricking where I'm from, Gary. I ain't never been that.
Oh, okay.
Now, you was just talking about all the things that were going on, like the secret recordings, the tapes, and that y'all still managed to live in the same house. Do y'all speak still?
Yeah, I'm not that. Gary know me. You guys know me. Rock T's, Ricky, y'all know me. I'm a very cordial guy. I never get upset, man. Only time I raise my voice when I'm coaching kids. So I'm very low key, and I'm real subdued like that. You know, totally opposite of what I'm on television. That's my television personality. But I'm not volatile whatsoever. And you know, I look at what's really going on, man. The enemy is really after what I do and what I'm doing for these babies. It's not even about her whatsoever. So I have a mission, and I have to stay focused no matter what it is.
Okay, Deion Sanders on the line, and I think there's been, well, maybe not conflicting stories. I know that there's some talk about a prenuptial agreement and $1 million. I've been divorced before, and I know sometimes they can be easy, sometimes they're harder. Is the big uproar the fact that she wants more money? What is it all about?
It's all about money. And unfortunately, you know, I hate to even have this conversation, but it's all about money. I have a prenuptial, and my prenuptial is trumped tight, and I'm cool with it.
Okay.
I'm fine with it. I took care of my business before we walked down that aisle. So I'm cool with it. And that's the thing. I mean, money makes you more of whom you really are, and unfortunately, that's what it's doing right now.
And there's no way possible on this green earth that y'all could work it out, probably get back together. Valentine's Day coming up, you know.
did you hear that silence?
I heard it.
Deion, can't you just be a man about it like most men? Just walk away and let her have everything. You can start all over again.
Okay, Gary.
No, Gary.
No, Gary. Why not? I mean, my brother did it.
Your brother didn't play football. He was a cheerleader like you. Anyway, Brian, send us some Sherry's berries or something.
Gary, you can't walk away. Gary, if I walk away and let them have the home, which who's going to pay the bills for the home?
Well, she could work.
Y'all give it up to Deion. Prime time, Sunday. Hey, Prime, I'm with you, dog.
There's not a house, no, because the home is paid for, but the upkeep of the home is tremendous. So you can't walk away and leave something like that in someone's hands that don't have the ability to.
Well, I'd be damn glad when I get mine paid for. God bless you. Hey, Rick. All right, Rick is about to board the show.
Thank you, Deion.
Thanks.
God is good. Hey, love y'all. Thank y'all for giving this platform for the babies.
Hey, love you too, man. Peace.